Yes, I'm going to do my October favorites in a onesie. Specifically a penguin onesie, and I'm going to tell you guys three good reasons why I'm wearing this. One, I am slightly cold right now. Two, I love onesies, and they are part of my October favorites. And three, the most important reason, because I can! I actually did purchase a lot of onesies in October, which was technically last month. I was gonna say this month, but it's November already, and Thanksgiving is around the corner, Christmas is around the corner, and that is just darn crazy. Three onesies in total. One amazing Ninja Turtle onesie, which is shown now. That is from Target. Target also has a Wonder Woman one and a Batwoman one, if I'm correct. And the other two were from Amazon. One was my Halloween costume, and I did a cat Halloween tutorial if you haven't seen it. It's there. It was a little late because, well, I didn't really plan on filming a tutorial, but I did a get ready with me instead. Favorite number two is very small, but you might have seen me wearing it in a couple videos, seen me wearing it in a couple pictures, and I have a close-up shot for you guys right now. It is a necklace, which I have in two different colors. I have it in gold and I have it in silver, but I primarily wear the silver a lot. Though, my skin tone looks better in gold, my hair looks better in silver. It is a name necklace, and I remember when name belts used to be really cool. Do you guys remember those belts that like had the light up electronic thing where you could change what the word said on the electronic one or the non-electronic ones? I was the girl who wore it all the time. I'm not even sure if I can find a picture of that, but if I can, I'll post it, but I was that girl. So having a name necklace is kind of weird to me because it's actually in now. It's really dainty. Like, the dainty ones are cute. The really huge ones are not cute, in my opinion. That's kind of like ratchet. Yes, that is the fancy word for ratchet. I will leave the information down below if you guys are interested in getting one for yourself. They were around $30 a piece, and I love them so much. They're just dainty, and they go with any other outfit. And I had mine, of course, say Sandwich, because it's not only my identity and screen name on YouTube, but it's my nickname. A little side note about my hair. If you haven't noticed, it is way darker now. I will talk about it towards the end of the video because I want to get through these favorites first, but if you're interested, stay tuned till the end. Follow me on Instagram, or if you watch my vlog channel, you guys already know that I am starting to go to the gym. I have a gym membership. It's the first time I've ever had a membership in the 22 years I have been alive, and it's the first time I really cared about fitness at all. And I'm not saying I'm going crazy, but it's pretty like weird for me to want to work out. It's just, it's odd. I'm just trying to better myself as a person just for my own sake, no one else. I have some new fitness favorites. I figured I would show them to you guys, you know, along the way. So my favorite sports bra of the month is one from Victoria's Secret. And I'd say I don't own lots of sports bras, but I do try a lot on. Like, you know, I went to Marshall's, went to Nike. And for my chest, or lack thereof chest situation, I did breastfeed two kids, and I have like less than the itty bitty titty committee now. I need a sports bra with some padding and one that is comfortable, and I like neutral colors currently, but I will eventually get others. But this is my favorite, and it's from Victoria's Secret. I will leave the name and everything on the screen and down below. They are kind of pricey, but I did enjoy the fact that in store they were giving out $10 off coupons for sports bras. On another fitness note, I have a very large box of protein bars. My favorite protein bar is by Quest, and it is the banana nut muffin flavor. I like this flavor enough to buy an entire box of it, and my daughter Ava loves it as well, so she always steals a couple bites from it. It has 20 grams of protein, so if you're looking for a protein bar that is a little bit more solid, not too granola-y, then this is a great one. You see this bag? This bag contains my last non-beauty favorite for the month. Utterly obsessed with Pringles. Pringles are a type of cookie. I have no clue what the real description is for them. If I find a good one, I will type it on the screen. But they are amazing. They are basically crack in a cookie. So in love with you. To the point that I drive to get these whenever my local bakery, which is called Cameron's Chocolate, makes them. And they make them maybe twice a week, three times max, but sporadic. And I call like almost every day to see if they have some. And I buy all of them when I go. I'm that chick. It's like a brownie covered in powdered sugar. I pretty much, that's exactly what it tastes like. It tastes like a brownie with powdered sugar with a cookie consistency. The outside is a little bit more firm, but the inside is soft and like chewy. It is the best thing. I'm not the type to like crunchy cookies, but this is not crunchy. It's just the perfect consistency of like a good brownie that's not too mushy. I had to wait a minute. Mm-hmm. Now I know what you're thinking. Sam, where are the beauty favorites? Hello, you're a beauty guru. You're correct, and here they are. First things first, I'm the realist. And second thing is, this amazing Lorac palette is something you just need to get your hands on. Okay, so If you've been living under a rock, this is the Lorac Mega Pro Palette. It's huge. It's the size of two regular Pro Palettes. And let me just make a disclaimer that I did not like the Lorac Pro Palette number one. I didn't like the consistency of it. I did not like how they blended whatsoever specifically. So I ended up selling mine on a blog sale. I never picked up the second one because I didn't really care for the colors. Now you're going to think, why did you even bother getting this? So, it's limited edition, and I bought this from their website. Amazon also had it. It sold out the first day, of course, they launched. I'm wearing some of the shadows right now. I'm definitely in love with this camel color. It is beautiful. All the colors are gorgeous. Indigo, like, I know it's like breathtaking. They're just amazing. And I love that the tone of the palette itself is, of course, half matte, half shimmer. You have 16 of each type. All the colors are very flattering for my skin tone. It's just amazing. All the browns are gorgeous. Some of the browns I definitely do not have in my collection. I didn't get as much fallout. There is some fallout, but it blended really, really, really well. So I think this is amazing. This powder, which I am wearing on my face right now, this is from Shea Moisture. I'm not sure if you guys have fully heard of the brand, but it is a brand that usually you'll see in like body washes and shampoo. And I saw this on It's My Ray Ray's channel. I saw that she ordered a bunch of products. I made sure I looked online to see if they were in my stores, found one, and I decided to try this. This is shade Tropea Almond. Tropea Almond. This is the second shade in the entire line. The first shade is a little paler, so if I got a little paler, maybe like an NC20, then I would be the first shade. But any NC30s or 35s, you're gonna have to lean towards the second shade in the line. This line is based towards medium to tanner to deeper skin tones. There's not basically any fair shades whatsoever. And I love this powder because in combination with my Dior Star foundation, which I did a review this month for, which I'll link over here, it is the most amazing, poreless, smoothless finish of my life. It's a good drugstore powder, and definitely my favorite drugstore powder now. Mm-hmm. This is the NARS Limited Edition Virtual Domination. I do love that name. Virtual domination. I take it more as like an empowerment thing, but let's be honest, everything that NARS names is usually frisky and sexual because that's just how they roll. But I think this blush palette is amazing. I'm wearing two of the shades right now. I'm wearing the contour color and the matte peach color as my blush. It is beautiful. It is amazing quality. It is a great value. And I don't know what else to say except for if you can get your hands on it, this is definitely a holiday palette I recommend. Hold up, hold up, hold up, hold up. I tried a new sheet mask brand and you need to know about it. So, you ain't see that. This brand is called Tsaio? T-S-A-I-O. This comes with 10 pieces per box. The thing about this, you cannot order anything but a box. So when you order, you'll be ordering 10 pieces. This is not like my other brands where you can order one at a time, which is good and bad thing. This is something that I would order in bulk because it's so affordable. For a box of 10, they are $10, and that's without any coupon code. With my coupon code, it is cheaper, so check that out. I have the super firming one, which is the orange, and then I have the deep whitening mask, which is the white, which is what I usually use for acne scars, and obviously firming is for firming. Those days that my face looks like it's falling off. Definitely one of my new favorite sheet mask brands in general. And like I said, great for the price. So if you're looking for some to try out, they have hydrating ones, these, and another one which slips my mind right now. You guys made the Leaders mask so sold out that I had to try something new, which isn't a bad thing. I realize this video is getting a little long. I apologize. Whatever. I wanted to talk about this NYX Wonderstick Contour Pencil. It's a double-sided highlight and contour cream stick. A lot of people wanted me to compare this to the Emma Cosmetics Chiaroscuro contour stick, which I do own, so let me know down below or thumbs up this video if you guys want to see that. Then I will see if it's something worth filming. I use shade medium just for reference, but I wanted to shout this Wonderstick out because it's one of the only cream highlighting sticks, or just generally contouring and highlighting products, that I really don't mind using because honestly, sometimes some of them are just a hassle to blend and you look dirty and you look muddy and you just look really like fake. But this doesn't do that, and this is really easy to blend. I think this is a great thing for those who are starting to get into highlighting and contouring a little more extremely, more than just a powder. It's really good for beginners. Last few things we're going to talk about are brushes. I wanted to talk about the IT Cosmetic brushes because I've been loving these this month. A couple of these, three of them, these three, were sent to me, and This huge one I purchased at Ulta because I was eyeing it like crazy. This is like one of the biggest brushes I've ever seen in my life. It's the biggest brush I own. It is ginormous, but it's so soft. It's so fluffy. I would like play with the tester over and over, and it's ridiculously like huge. It's bigger than my head. It's just very luxurious, and I love it, so I had to have it. But honestly, I love all these brushes. It Cosmetics themselves have a lot of like mini lines of brushes at Ulta, but I love the ones with this type of bristle, like the darker bristle at the end. They are just great for powder products. I love them for powder products. The double-ended one, I love to set my concealer with the skinny side, and I love to use this side for face powder. The blush brush is great for really pigmented blushes, so I use it with my NARS blushes all the time because it doesn't like make me into a clown. It's very nice and light. I was not sponsored to say that, but I will be doing a video next week. Actually, I did this makeup today using some of IT Cosmetics products. And now the last brushes to talk about would be the flat top that I featured in my Dior Star Foundation review. If you haven't seen it, I will mention it again. This is the Flat Kabuki from Beauty Junkies, and it is sold on Amazon, and it is sold for $11. Yeah, I said it. $11. And I have a $5 off coupon code. Yeah, do the math. That's $6 and some change. I think that is amazing, and I know what you're thinking. It looks just like the Sigma, this is the Sigma one, F80 Kabuki brush that everyone goes crazy for. And yes, it is just as good, if not better. I'm pretty sure I shouldn't be saying that on YouTube, but oh well, I'm honest. And I think if you can get your hands on it, if it's like one of the best sellers on Amazon, you can go look at it yourself. Like, there is so many reviews for it. It is way worth the money. I'm going to be trying a couple of the other brushes this upcoming month, so we'll see if they make it into my November favorites. But it is a very nice, dense, wide brush. It's just a little bit... Actually, no, it's pretty much identical. But for some reason, I love the density of this brush a little bit more than the Sigma one. So I've been leaning towards it way more. And I guess something just like a little bit more lighter in the hand, I just grab for it more. And it's amazing for foundation or cream or powder or whatever you want to use it for. It's amazing for it, and it's so affordable. And my $5 off coupon code works for any of their products, their sponges or their other brushes. So feel free to check out the info box down below for more info. This is a pretty long video, but honestly, we needed to catch up. We needed to talk, socialize. This is what I love about monthly favorite videos. Now let me go into a big hair ramble. Okay, I'm not gonna ramble at all, but for those who care, I have darker hair now. Can you see it? It's darker, and it's less silvery. It's barely it's not barely silver. I guess it's like a darker gray again, but basically I go in for a monthly root touch-up, because I have to, because roots grow. And during my monthly root touch-up, my hair, I knew this was going to happen eventually, it gave up. It was done. It's going to hit that point, because silver is very damaging. Having to, you know, bleach your hair that light all the time is very damaging. It's like probably the most damaging color you could go for from Asian hair. If you are Caucasian, or if you have blonde hair or just light brown hair, you can stay silver much longer than me. But from a black haired head, it's very hard to go to the complete opposite side of the spectrum, which is platinum blonde silver. Most of it's actually pretty good, but to be specific, the top of the crown of my head gave up, and there was a crap ton of breakage to the point that my stylist was like, you know, we can't keep your roots silver. We can keep the rest of it. Like, the rest of it's silver. Like, it's still pretty shiny. But we had to kind of do, like, an ombre. So we did a dark brown fading into an ash brown into what's left of my silver. Now I know what you're thinking. Sam, why didn't you just do your whole head dark? And I was perfectly fine going with all over ash brown. But my hair is special. It has special needs. Because the ends will not hold dark color and the top will not hold light color. So, figure that one out. Basically, eventually I will have an all-over, probably unison hair color again. But currently, we will be doing a funny-looking ombre. But it's not funny-looking. I think it actually looks pretty beast and pretty cool. If you look at it, like, look at that. I think it looks pretty beast. Kind of. I don't know. I find it cool. It's definitely darker right now, which I think is cool. Like, I will play with other colors. I'll play with, like, you know, purple tones and stuff like that. But my roots are going to need to stay dark for a while my hair decides to repair itself from the torture I put it through. I wanted to give you guys an explanation because now my hair is definitely darker, but I think it's pretty cool. What do you think? Thank you guys, as always, for watching. Happy November, and I will see you guys in a later video. Bye. I didn't choose the thug life chose me.